She leads Wilson to the lounge. The couch has been tipped up and is riddled with bullet holes. There are more in the walls. This time tomorrow, every inch of the lounge will have been examined and every bullet tracked back to where it was fired. There is blood on the carpet and something she can't at first identify, then realizes is a piece of Burroughs's tongue. Her phone goes. It's the officer she called earlier at the Garrett house. She stares at Wilson while she listens. Wilson is paler than usual, and she knows why. He misread the situation. Hayes, Burroughs, and Keith were always going to come after James. She suspects he's going to go even paler when she tells him what she just learned on the phone. But first, she needs to confirm it. She goes back down to the bedroom where Hazel and James are waiting. Both have dressed over the last few minutes, and both are sitting on the edge of the bed. "I called the officers at your house," Kent says. "They're looking around to see if there are any indications these men went there last night." "And?" Hazel asks. "Is there any reason one of the couch cushions would be outside, beside the garage?" Hazel shakes her head. She looks confused. "A couch cushion?" Kent checks her phone. The officer said he would text her a picture, and he has. She shows it to Hazel. "It's definitely ours," Hazel says. "But I don't understand why it would be outside." "Was it on your couch last night?" "Yes. I mean, I can't be sure, but there's no reason it shouldn't have been, let alone end up outside."